I think this will rank as the toughest interview I've had, but I enjoyed it nonetheless. Obviously, I'm originally from Katlehong, and I grew up in the 80s there, and with a bit of luck, I studied for a few years abroad and subsequently spent time in, I was both here and also in Geneva, came back to South Africa in 1999 after finishing my postdoctoral research fellowship at a laboratory called CERN in Geneva, to take up a position at the University of Cape Town as a lecturer. And subsequent to that, I became a director of a nuclear research facility in Cape Town, and then came here in 2014 as DVC Research. I was born in 1969 at the heart of apartheid. In fact, there was a law called the Bantu Education Act just passed, even kind of 14 years before I was born. So I was a bit of a maverick in a sense that I actually chose kind of fundamental physics and kind of like hard sciences when it was, not popular. You know, that those days, actually, most of the, I'd say, promising children would go into the professions, teaching medicine and law. So the options were very narrow, let alone engineering at the time. I mean, never knew what an engineer was. And then I just decided that, actually, I'd rather do kind of physics as just something for my intellectual stimulation, because I wanted to be an astronaut. I had a very strict father, so being lazy was not tolerated. Skipping class was not tolerated at all. So kind of dodging, as we used to call it those days, what was punished severely. There was a bit of that, I mean, honest to be aware, because I grew up in an area where I grew up, there were many gangsters in place. In fact, my biggest role models were not the nerdy type academics. Some of my biggest role models were the tough guys in town. And those are the kind of heroes of the day, in a funny way, because they were the men about town, right? They wore the fanciest clothes. Of course, you had sports role models. I liked sport as a kid, and that was also, those are the kind of two non-academic routes that one could think of, actually. And I think it was not for so far that I admired some of the tough guys who were staff riders, moving trains, train surfers. You call it staff riding, but the train surfers were the coolest guys you could find in town because they were taking all the risks. Okay. Not something that the VC should talk about, but that's my background. The neighborhood I grew up in was quite a tough one. Yes, what my first job was, apart from chores, was to work at a company called Console Glassworks. I was 17 years old, or 16 years old, just about finishing my matric, and it was what called December holidays. So working basically in a blow molding firm. Console is a company that used to produce plastic bottles, like Stay Soft bottles and everything. It was actually in Wadeville, which is an industrial area around the East Rand, next to Katlehong, right? Huge industrial belt. So my uncle worked there, and during December, because people would be going home, so they would have the vacation space for, young students who want to earn extra cash. And it was back-breaking work. And I think I bought my first watch and my first CD, LP rather, with that money. I think I left that job leaner, but with more muscles. I think I've never been as muscular as I was after I left, because we used to load crates of sacks, about 20 kilograms sacks of powder that was going to be loaded into this machine and be molten in a molten state for blow molding into any shape for bottles and so on and so forth. So it was actually, it was called a 6-to-6 job. Started 6 in the morning, ended 6 at night for 3 weeks. I really earned my salary, and I really thought to myself, I'm never going to be a laborer again. And actually, that motivated me to actually, you know, take my studies seriously. Like all teenage boys, I was still distracted by many things like football and other things. So therefore, that made me sharpen my focus a little bit. From life in the universe. All that surrounds me, inspires me. Family, friends, people I work with, you know, and just a gaze up to the stars, galaxies, and explore inner space of atoms. That just inspires me. Nature inspires me, actually. Kind of fascination with knowledge inspires me. Typical of any executive, he left me some notes that are for my eyes only. You know, like for example, they say that when the US president enters office, the outgoing president writes handwritten notes for the eyes, not only of the president who's the occupier of the Oval Office, right? Not the chief of staff, not the military, not even intelligence. So likewise, yeah, when the outgoing VC Prof. Habib left, he pointed me to a set of notes, handwritten on his on the top drawer, so typed top secret, and they are sealed and locked in a vault elsewhere. My biggest childhood dream was to be a heavyweight boxing champion of the world, and I never grew to, 6 feet three, 1.9 meters. I found myself a bit shy of 5 feet 11, at about 1.8 meters. So I even knew the count, I even know statistics in Imperial, because when you watch TV, getting up at 4 in the morning, they would tell you that this boxer weighs 200 pounds, standing at 5'11 or 6'6'2, 6'6'3. So I knew even then how to convert between that without a calculator. The second dream was to become a pilot, a fighter pilot, which is why I chose, I thought physics would be the way to gateway to that, because all astronauts were fighter pilots, and possibly become the general of the Air Force. That didn't, so I settled for physics. About six. I'm a native Isizulu speaker, and therefore I understand this Swati, because some of my family are Swati actually. People say you are Swatis, you became Zulus, you know, when you moved to Joburg. So I speak Swati quite well, and because I lived in the Cape for many years, and growing up in Gauteng, I have a kind of a broader understanding of Xhosa, and I think my Xhosa is quite good. Sisutu and Setswana, I can speak reasonably okay. So I grew them into groups, like Nguni languages and Sotho languages. I had to learn, having stayed in for many years in Switzerland, French and German, and my French became quite good at some stage, if I can say so myself, but now with time I have not. And I can read Russian now, Cyrillic, which is an interesting script, and I like the mathematics behind it, because you just got to follow the logic, but I can't speak it. But I can read and I can translate from Cyrillic into Latin script, which is quite, just for fun.
Can you say something for us in French?
Hmm?
Can you say something in French for us?
Je m'appelle Zeblon Villagazi, je suis vice-chancellor de la Université de l'Université Wattesrand, Johannesburg, Afrique du Sud. I can say something in Russian. Привет. Zeblon Villagazi, rector, Universität Witwatersrand, Johannesburg. Спасибо большое. До свидания. I'm a night owl. It takes me a while to ramp up. I think at night, I think I'm much more, I can plot better at night. Because I like strategy. Coffee. I'm a coffee addict. That's one of my vices.